is the highest honor the National Television Awards can bestow. And this year's recipient is a true giant of broadcasting. To co-create, write, and perform in one of the most influential comedy series of all time would be more than enough for most. But this man then went on single-handedly to change the face of documentaries with his groundbreaking travel series Around the World in 80 Days. Since then, he's become one of our best-loved television travelers. He's a phenomenal actor. He's a comedy icon. He's a clanger and a python. And I'm delighted to say he's also my friend. Let's look back at this incredible man's work.
Distinct as characters.
Next. Crucifixion. Yes. Good. Out of the door, line on the left, one cross each.
Mike was very subtle sort of acting. I think out of all the pythons, he was probably the most versatile actor of them all.
Now,
Around the World in 80 Days was must-watch television.
No matter what?
This was different.
I mean, to go around the world.
And that was a joy to see the real Michael Palin.
Strange and wonderful things in strange and wonderful countries.
These travel documentaries have always been adventures, but the early ones, I seem to remember large sections of them being unplanned.
I need a boat.
Yes.
To take me to Bombay.
Oh, yes, why not? And then we
can. Somebody who presents travel log, you have to have a genuine interest in people. You can't fake that. You can't pretend to like people. Because after 3 or 4 days, you know, it's going to show.
I'm Michael.
Oh, good. Well, happy. Thank you very much. I'm Mustafa Shergi.
Mustafa Shergi.
Yes.
Here we were seeing someone who was joyed at the meeting of people and the gaining of new experiences.
I mean, where else in the world would I be off skinny dipping with two gentlemen I only just met?
But also somebody who was tired and someone who was ill and someone who was sick.
I'm almost knackered to a standstill. It's pathetic. I had to give my pack to somebody. I've become like a patient.
There is sort of perhaps an idea that it's just you and the crew sitting around the swimming pool not doing much. But of course, any TV company is going to send you halfway around the world. You're going to work really hard.
Nothing seems to be happening. I'm totally unqualified for any milk of any kind. I don't have that milk.
Recognize in huge portions of the world, and they will welcome him because they recognize him as an old friend.
Your face, very familiar to me because of BBC.
Oh, really? Your face, very familiar to me.
But also, there are these places he goes to, the tribes he'll speak to, that won't have any knowledge of Monty Python or his previous work, and yet still he's able to gain people's trust.
He came on a trip with his son who was called Kermit. Yeah, honestly.
You know, there's kind of innocence as well about those documentaries, which is incredibly appealing.
Bedtime. Off you go.
They don't feel cynical. They kind of humanised areas of the world or cultures that people had preconceptions about.
I
suspect this gentleman is a frustrated Fred Astaire.
He's looking for those human connections. What are the things that make us who we are?
Buttons.
Up. As opposed to the differences. It's the ordinary people that will give you that.
I didn't have anyone in mind when I was writing. It wasn't valid for any of the parts, really, but I knew I needed a veteran actor with a screen presence and gravitas.
Hello.
But essentially a brilliant comedian. And when you feed all that data into a computer, it comes up with some like a paper.
Children. Exactly.
I think he's a terrific actor.
They're in the future.
When he has played dramatic parts.
Come, Virgil.
He's been utterly convincing in them.
Let's go for a walk.
When you look at his career, it's extraordinary that he's been on our screens consistently from the late 60s. And he's been consistently funny throughout all that.
Where have you been, Your Majesty? Where have you been? Where have you been?
This is it. Standing on the top of the world.
It is that driven curiosity. Desire to connect with people and to show other people that it's possible to connect.
How can I survive without you?
Lots of people, including myself, have followed in his footsteps, but in terms of his quest for knowledge and his interest in people, there is none better.
Is it not enough for a cappuccino?
When I first blew up the world, seemed an incomprehensibly huge distance to cover. Now I've covered it, I can't quite grasp what I've done.
Thank you, Wilson.
Well, I think it is
quite hard to grasp what Mike has done. And what I admire most about Mike is he set a... He's been a role model for all the people who, like himself, are not particularly talented. And he's shown these people that by virtue of hard work and making relationships with the right people, you can get somewhere near the top. He's also done wonderful things for insomnia. So I think you know that the Travel Series is in fact sponsored by the American Association of Insomniacs. Michael has given a good night's rest to people who otherwise have not been able to sleep a single hour in their lives. Well done, Sir Michael.
Please welcome Sir Michael Palin!